not good at this, so bear with me. Don't do a lot of these, so I'm gonna suck at it, but that's why I'm a redneck. Alright, I just got this a couple days ago. I ordered it November 17th. Now I got it December 2nd or 3rd. Took like 16 days to get here from China, which I think is fantastic. So let's open this up. I've had three or four other electric skateboards. Started with the swag board. You know, wasn't bad for what it was. Then I got a Blitz Art Tornado, which was decent board, never had any problems with it. Then I moved up to a real V1S, never had any problems with it. And now my favorite board is a V-Star City SUV. So I saw Andrew Penman do a video on this BeastBoard. Great price, I think $550 with the discount code. So we're going to check it out. Seen some reviews on the wheels, not the board itself, but the YouTube video I saw on the wheels was great. All right, so board's kind of backwards. See it there. Just take it out. I know the lighting in here sucks, sorry. Got the honeycomb wheels like the V-Star City SUV. Skateboard tool. Couple spare belts. Bunch of wristbands. Charging cable. Another wristband. Remote. Which I think I'm going to like this remote. It's got the digital readout, which my V-Star and my Gorilla don't. Charging cable adapter. And, of course, the charger itself. I think the wheels on here, forget what they call these wheels. They got a special name. It's not cloud wheels, but it's something like that. I think they're 110 millimeter. See how they compare to my Vareal. Now the Vareal I put mini AT wheels on. That was a board that Vareal sold for maybe like a week, but they pulled it because Vic thought the wheels wore out too fast, which they do, but he sold them to me for a good price. Because the wheels that come with the V1S just too small in my neighborhood. The roads are terrible where I ride, and I like to ride in Galveston on the seawall, and it's rough there, so I need some better wheels. So I think you can see how those compare. They're about the same size, but the BeastBoard wheels, I'm sure, are going to be a lot better ride. As you can see the V-Star C SUV wheels are a lot bigger than the BeastBoard. I think they're 150 millimeters on the V-Star, and they just soak up the bumps. It's not a great carver, but the ride is fantastic. I've never had a bump, and I go over some big ones, cracks, huge chunks of road missing where it's throwing me off. So I'm looking forward to testing out this board, doing a range test on it. We'll do a speed test. I'll probably compare it to the city SUV and see which one goes faster. Maybe I'll take the Vareal with me too, and we'll check it out, see how it goes. It looks like it's already charged up, I think. Let's check it out. Where's the on off on this? Making a noise like a jet engine when it starts up. You can hear something going on in there. Yeah, it's showing the batteries are fully charged. You see, I'm sure you can't see that readout, too far away. I don't have a fancy camera system, or there's not gonna be any fancy editing going on either, cause I ain't got that shit, so we'll see how it goes. See if I can figure out if this thing will go from kilometers to miles per hour, probably not. But that's okay. I'm gonna take it out for a ride, and I'll show you the footage, and we'll see what happens. Thanks for watching. Just wanted to do a quick video of the back of the board showing the enclosures compared to the other three boards that I have. That one right there, that it doesn't count. This is the Viril V1S. Then you have the Beast board. Then you have the V-Star board City SUV. The V-Star board City SUV has the 150 millimeter wheels, honeycomb. 110 millimeters on the Beast board. I think these are about 100 millimeters on the Viril. These actually, they never really put out, maybe for a week. It's called a mini AT board. This board actually came with these wheels, but I took it off and put it on this other board to put on these because got big cracks in my neighborhood. Those wheels better. They pulled it off the market because the wheels didn't last long enough. Tread wore out too quick. So here's the back of the Beast board enclosure. They're built pretty well. Others have pointed out if that, it looks like water would get in there pretty easily. I guess it would let it cool better, but water's going to get in there for sure. So that's one thing to consider. V-Star board closure. I like it. It's pretty sealed up. It has no flex whatsoever on that board though. But you can't tell it with those big honeycomb wheels. It's still probably a more comfortable ride than the Beast board is. But I think this one, I think the V-Star board is probably like 300 more now with the battery I have in it anyway. I like the fact that these lights light up at night. So that's a cool feature. So that's just showing you the back of the boards I have for comparison. So that's
here
it.
Here we go. Get through this first set here, so I don't bust my ass.
Video there because I shot a lot of footage and most of it sucks. Like I said in the beginning, I'm not good at this. Just a redneck country boy trying to make a video to try and help some others that, since this just came out, maybe not have know anything about it yet. And the footage that I shot, it was windy and you can't hear what I'm saying, so I'm just gonna cut out most of the video, let you see some of it, and I'm just going to verbally tell you some of the stats, and I'll post it. It should be scrolling right here, my speed levels and all that. It's not posting there, is it? Because I don't know how to do it. So let's talk about the board. The wheels were great. I'm going to show a little bit of footage of the streets in my neighborhood, going the bumps that I'd go over with these wheels, and how it took it, soaked them up great. There's a lot of flex in this board, as you might have seen in some other videos. As far as range goes, I went to this park and I did almost 17 miles. It was windy as hell. I was going against the wind a lot. Got almost 17 miles, averaging 15 miles per hour. As far as speed goes, I got 28 miles per hour top speed, which to me is hauling ass. That's faster than I'm ever going to go. I usually am cruising around 15 miles an hour. I got a beer in one hand and I'm vaping in the other hand and I'm listening to my tunes, and so that's what I do with my board. So let's talk about the remote. The remote's supposed to be the latest Hobby Wing design. It tells you how fast you're going, how many miles that you have traveled so far. Looks like it'll keep it for the life of the board, how many miles you're going to put on it or kilometers. Tells you what speed mode you're in and your battery levels of the remote and the board. So that's pretty cool too. So I'd say for $550, you need to go get one. I think it's a pretty good deal. We'll see over time how it holds up, and I'll probably make another video on down the road, another sucky video, but that's all right. Thanks for watching my Redneck Adventures. Okay, this is me driving through my neighborhood, showing the roads, how the cracks, how bad the roads are, how good the board absorbs them. It was doing a pretty good job. I'm very happy with the wheels and the way it soaked up the road here. Alright, here's a change of scenery. I went to the park. Start my range test, but here I'm trying to do another top speed test and see how fast I can get the board up to here. But the wind is blowing pretty hard, which you've heard me say a number of times. So here I go. I'm taking off, trying to get up to speed. I thought that this board would probably do 30 miles per hour, but under better circumstances, I'm sure it would. But the best I could do right here was 26. So then I move on here in the middle of the range test. Here I'm about the 6 mile mark.
Not sure how much life I have left in these
batteries. I'm talking about battery levels and
this remote yet.
A lot of mumbo jumbo that I'm not sure what I'm saying right now.
The board's pretty torquey. So far I'm liking it. Ride is pretty smooth. Goes over these wooden planks on these bridges pretty good that I'm fixing to come up on. Sorry, I've lost my selfie stick.
Oh, here, I think I'm about to go through the grass. Maybe. I know at some point I go in the grass to see how well it will do. Oh, no, I'm coming up on this bridge and it goes over these wooden planks. Pretty good. Absorbs those bumps real good. So here's where I go into the grass. I tested it out on in the grass in some other clips. I just didn't put them on here, but it handled it real well. I was not really surprised, but happy with the results. Right here in this clip, my remote started vibrating on me, and I didn't know it was going to do that. Every time it did it, by the time I got the remote up to my face, I couldn't see what it said, but I finally figured it out, and it was saying low voltage. But I still had 2 bars on the remote, so as far as the battery reading goes on the board, I had 2 bars, so I was confused at why it was saying low voltage when I still had 2 bars left.
Still showing 2 bars.
So the more I ride it, we're going to see if it still keeps doing that. I thought I was going to have to shut it down because it kept saying that. It probably vibrated 4 or 5 times, maybe more. And I'm headed to my car here and I'm about to shut it down, but I decide not to. I keep riding. So here I've stopped for a second to doing some power slides with the board. So it's got a lot of torque, has pretty good power. And at this point, I've put another 4 kilometers on the board since it first started vibrating. So it's not vibrating anymore, and it's not giving me that low voltage indicator.
The remote quit so vibrating about
I'm not sure how that operates.
With the low voltage indicator.
It's the camera that's making it flash like that. When you're looking at it in real life, it doesn't. That remote doesn't flash like that. That's just the camera making it do that.
I don't know what
I'm like at 26 kilometers here, and we're 15.6 miles.
26 kilometers. See how many miles that is. I'm at 15.6 miles. And looks like I got some left. Alright, now I'm down to one bar. I'm a little over 16 miles.
So here I'm bringing it home. Down to one bar.
But the board battery's down to one bar.
About at 16 miles, 16 and a half miles, so I'm going to stop it. I think I could have, the battery's not completely gone, and there's no battery sag whatsoever, it doesn't feel like. So I'm about to shut it down, but there, no one going to run it till the battery completely died. So I still have battery left. Like I say, I got about 16 and a half miles.
Guys, back at the house.